हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर निमलांशु हियर। सो लास्ट क्लास में हमने पढ़ा था कि डाल्टन्स लॉ ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर एंड ग्राहम्स लॉ ऑफ डिफ्यूजन। ओके, और मैंने ये बात ही बोला था कि ग्राहम्स लॉ ऑफ डिफ्यूजन और डाल्टन्स लॉ ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर को लेकर कुछ न्यूमेरिकल्स है जो हम मतलब आज की क्लास में सॉल्व करेंगे। सो व्हाट इज ग्राहम्स, व्हाट इज डाल्टन्स लॉ ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर, लेट अस रिमाइंड वंस अगेन बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द न्यूमेरिकल्स। So Dalton's law state that which was given by John Dalton. So he has studied that he has enclosed in a vessel mixture of two or three gases. Suppose in the room in which you are sitting, it is a mixture of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Also hydrogen is also there. Nitrogen is also there. So now, but these gases do not react chemically with each other. These gases do not react chemically with each other. So if so happens, then what will happen? The total pressure of the vessel is equal to the summation of a partial pressures of all the gases. Okay, under similar conditions of temperature and pressure. Okay, so under similar conditions of temperature, this total pressure is equal to the partial pressure of the individual gases which do not react chemically with each other. This is all about Dalton's law of partial pressure. Next, coming to Graham's law of diffusion. Thomas Graham has studied that gases diffuse very readily with each other. So what we can do? We can take a vessel which is fitted with a lid. Now in the lower portion of the vessel, if we take reddish brown color of nitrogen dioxide, and in the upper portion of the vessel, means above the lid, if we take, I have shown that one in my previous class in a diagram, then if we take colorless hydrogen gas and if we remove the lid, what will happen? The whole color of the total vessel will be light brown nitrogen dioxide. Okay, light brown color means the gases, reddish brown nitrogen dioxide, has diffused readily and mixed with colorless hydrogen gas. So based on that, Thomas Graham has studied the rates of diffusion of gases, and he has stated that, and he has come out with a generalization that rate of diffusion of a gas is inversely proportional to the square root of their density under similar conditions of temperature and pressure. And in my last class, we have seen that if there are two gases are present, so that is R proportional 1 by root over D. R proportional 1 by root over D. So under similar conditions of at constant temperature and pressure, so if there are two gases, then R1 by R2 is equal to root over D2 by D1. Now what we can do, we can multiply both the numerator and denominator by 2, so twice D2 by twice D1, which is equal to root over M2 by M1, because we know that we have studied in our first unit, that is basic concepts of chemistry, that molecular mass of a gas is equal to twice the density of the gas. It is twice the density of the gas. Now coming to the time taken for diffusion, that is rate is equal to volume of gas diffused by time taken for diffusion. That is R proportional to 1 by root over T. Now here again, if we have two gases, that is root over that is R1 by R2 is equal to root over T2 by T1. Okay, now taking all these things, we can say that therefore we can write root over T2 by T1 is equal to root over D2 by D1. Root over D2 by D1 is equal to root over M2 by M1, which all R is equal to, which all equals to R1 by R2. This is Graham's law of diffusion. अभी Graham's law of diffusion और Dalton's law partial pressure को लेकर कुछ problems करेंगे, लेकिन before going to the problems, I want to say you one thing, that these gases, hydrogen gas, especially hydrogen gas, what we do when we synthesize hydrogen gas in the laboratory, we collect these gases in over water because these gases do not react with water. So these are collected hydrogen, oxygen, methane, etc. These gases are collected over water. So these gases are collected like this. Suppose this is a vessel. So here we take water. So it is covered with a in this way it is collected. Okay. So this way it is collected. So here it will come, something will come like that. So hydrogen gas will or oxygen gas will be collected. Okay. Over water. Okay. So now means that inside the jar whatever we are recording, water vapors are also present in the jar. So whatever we are recording, that is the pressure of the moist gas and the dry gas. Okay. So the pressure of water vapor is also will come into account. So this pressure of water vapor, that is pressure of moist gas, is called aqueous tension. It is called aqueous tension of the gas. So whatever we to calculate the pressure of dry gas, what we have to do? We have to take the total pressure. Whatever pressure, suppose the total pressure is coming P. Total pressure of the jar is coming P. So the pressure of dry gas will be equal to pressure of dry gas will be equal to total pressure minus we have to minus out the pressure of the moist gas, that is aqueous tension. Okay, aqueous tension. So means that whenever we are collecting or whatever or whenever we are recording pressures of a gas which is collected over water, that pressure is not only of the gas, it is the total pressure of the dry gas as well as the pressure of water vapor. Now to calculate the pressure of dry gas, what we have to do? We have to minus out or deduce out the pressure of the water vapor, which is termed as aqueous tension. So pressure of dry gas will be equal to total pressure minus aqueous tension. अभी ये सबको लेके हम लोग अभी now we are going to solve some numericals based on this Dalton's law of partial pressure and Graham's law of diffusion. So let us write one question. You write, my dear students, the pressure of 1:2, the pressure of, I'll solve one or two problems and the rest problems are, and the rest numericals are there in NCERT book. You try to solve it on your own, and if you feel any doubt you can ask me, and I'm very happy that some students are regularly submitting the homework to me. I'm very happy for them, and I'm requesting to those students who have not yet already submitted your homework, you please do it and submit it back to me. So you can write one question. This is NCERT question. NCERT question. So the question is, the pressure of 1:4. The pressure of 1:4. Mixture of nitrogen and oxygen. Mixture of oxygen O2 and to nitrogen in a vessel is 1.5 atm, 1.5 atmosphere. Okay, what would be the partial pressure of nitrogen, partial pressure of dinitrogen in Newton per meter square, in Newton per meter square. Okay, so this is my question. Now let's see how to solve this one. So solution is, So what is said in the question that pressure of 1:4 mixture of oxygen and nitrogen which is enclosed in a vessel is 1.5 atmosphere. What would be the partial pressure of nitrogen in Newton per meter square? Okay. So now according to Dalton's law of partial pressure, so what we have seen last class, Dalton's law of partial pressure. और एक इक्वेशन था हमारा डाल्टन्स लॉ ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर को लेके, दैट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू डाल्टन्स लॉ ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर यू कैन राइट पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन बाय टोटल प्रेशर पी टोटल इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन बाय टोटल नंबर ऑफ मोल्स means the mole fraction that we have studied in our last class. Partial pressure of any gas is equal to mole fraction of that gas into total pressure of the gas. Okay. So number of moles of nitrogen by the total number of moles is equal to mole fraction. So n2 by n. So or we can write partial pressure of nitrogen by P. P total is how much? That is mixture का pressure कितना है? 1.5 atm. 1.5 atm is equal to number of moles of nitrogen कितना है? 4 है. Number of moles of nitrogen कितना है? 4 है. और total number of moles कितना है? तो 1 plus 4 is equal to 5. Which implies we can write P of N2 is equal to 4 by 5 into 1.5 atm. 1.5 atm, okay? So, is equal to 1.2 atm. So, ATM को अभी convert करना पड़ेगा Newton per meter square में because the question is asked to calculate the partial pressure of nitrogen in terms of Newton per meter square. Now, 1 ATM is equal to 101325 Newton per meter square which is equal to, you can write 1.2 into 101325 Newton per meter square which is equal to, we can write 1.216. 1.216 × 10⁵ Newton per meter square. Okay. In this way, we have to approach and solve the numericals. So the partial pressure of nitrogen is coming out to be 1.216 × 10⁵ Newton per meter square. Okay. So next और एक problem हम लोग देखते हैं. Let's see another problem. That is also a NCERT problem. The pressure that is also a NCERT problem. So I am saying that it is not at all possible for me to solve all the numericals in the class. So you people practice it on your own. There are NCERT problems are there in your NCERT book. I am pretty sure that all of you are having NCERT book. So, if people practice it from NCERT book, but wherever you feel any doubts or any queries regarding any problem, you are free to ask me. So, no matter, I am here to help you people. But the thing is that you people have to practice and because the more you will practice, the more you will be able to solve the problems in the examination hall needfully and carefully, okay? So, next, the pressure of a mixture of hydrogen and nitrogen. The pressure of a mixture of hydrogen and nitrogen is how much? 1200 torr. 1200 torr. It is also a unit of pressure. Okay. Now the partial pressure of nitrogen in the mixture is the partial pressure of nitrogen in the mixture. In the mixture is how much? 300 torr. Okay. So what question is? What is the ratio of hydrogen and nitrogen? What is the ratio of hydrogen and nitrogen? Nitrogen molecules in the mixture. Nitrogen molecules in the mixture. So this is the question. Now please go through the question once again. What is the question? The pressure of a mixture of hydrogen and nitrogen is 1200 torr. The pressure of nitrogen in the mixture is 300 torr. What is the ratio of the hydrogen and nitrogen molecules in the mixture? So how we will solve the problem? So partial pressure of total pressure in the of mixture is, so let's see the solution. Total pressure of mixture is, total pressure of mixture is equal to 1200 torr. Okay. Partial pressure of nitrogen. Partial pressure of nitrogen, that is PN2, is equal to 300 torr. So what is the partial pressure of hydrogen will be? So partial pressure of hydrogen will be is equal to pH2, small pH2 is equal to 1200 minus 300, that is equal to 900 torr. That is equal to 900 torr. So means that partial pressure of nitrogen is equal to 300 torr and partial pressure of hydrogen is equal to 900 torr. Okay. Now we know that according to gas equation, PV equal to, according to ideal gas equation, according to ideal gas equation, PV equal to nRT. That is, we can write P of H2 is equal to number of moles of H2 by into RT by number of moles of H2 into RT by V, and PN2 is equal to number of moles of nitrogen into RT by V. Okay. So which is equal to 900 torr, and this is hydrogen is equal to 900 torr. Okay, and this is equal to 300 torr. This is equal to 300 torr. Okay. Now what we will do? We will divide equation 1 by equation 2. This is equation 1. You can take this as equation 1 and you can take this as equation 2. So we have to find the ratio of H2 and N2 molecules in the mixture, no? So what we will do? We will divide this one equation, divide equation 1 by equation 2. So dividing equation 1 by equation 2, what we will get? So dividing equation 1 by 2, we will get what? Partial pressure of hydrogen by partial pressure of nitrogen is equal to 900 number of moles of hydrogen by number of moles of nitrogen. Okay, so this is equal to 900 by 300, that is equal to 3 is to 1. So number of moles of hydrogen is 2, number of moles of nitrogen is equal to 3 is to 1. Okay, so in this way we have to solve the numericals. In this way we have to approach and finally solve the numericals. Okay, so now these are 2 or 3 numericals I am doing. Rest you have to do it from on your own and from the NCERT books. Okay, so next we will see some problems related to Graham's law of diffusion. Related to Graham's law of diffusion, OBE NCERT problem here. So let's see the problem which I am going to do now is very very important, because this is a frequently asked question in your board exam. एंड ऑल्सो एज वेल एज इन योर एंट्रेंस एग्जाम एंट्रेंस एग्जाम पॉइंट इज कंसर्न इन नीट एंड आई टी JEE स्पेशली IIT JEE दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सो यू कैन गिव इट हाउ मेनी स्टार इफ यू लाइक यू कैन गिव इट सो द क्वेश्चन इज 200 ml ऑफ SO2 डिफ्यूज 200 ml ऑफ SO2 डिफ्यूज ओके थ्रू ए पोरस प्लग इन हाउ मेनी सेकेंड्स इन हाउ मेनी टाइम इन 600 seconds इन 600 seconds ओके 600 seconds नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट वॉल्यूम ऑफ मीथेन विल डिफ्यूज इन द सेम टाइम What volume of methane? Methane का फॉर्मूला क्या है my dear students? For the formula of methane, CH4 will diffuse in the same time. Okay, in the same time. So the solution how will you do the solution? Now, rate of diffusion of SO2 is equal to what is the rate of diffusion? Volume of gas diffused by the time taken for diffusion. So 200 by 600 ml per second. 200 by 600 ml per second. And the rate of diffusion of CH4 is equal to वॉल्यूम निकालना है व्हाट वॉल्यूम ऑफ मीथेन विल डिफ्यूज टाइम कितना है टाइम सेम टाइम में 600 ml पर सेकंड ओके नाउ रेट निकालने के लिए हमको मॉलिक्यूलर मास की जरूरत है सो मोलर मास ऑफ SO2 इज इक्वल टू हाउ मेनी 32 एंड मोलर मास ऑफ CH4 इज हाउ मेनी इज इक्वल टू 16 ओके So molar mass of SO2 is equal to 32 and molar mass of this one is equal to 16. Now according to Graham's law of diffusion, what is the Graham's law of diffusion that we have just now before starting the numericals we have discussed? That is rate of diffusion of SO2 divided by rate of diffusion of CH4 is equal to molecular mass of CH4 by molecular mass of SO2. Okay. So, this one is R SO2 कितना है हमारा 200 by 600 into 600 R SO2 कितना है 600 by V is equal to this one how much? This one is 16 by 32. That is 2. ओके 16 बाई 32 नहीं होना चाहिए बच्चों सो सॉरी मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ SO2 इज नॉट 32 सल्फर इज 32 प्लस 32 इज इक्वल टू 64 सो दैट वन इज इक्वल टू 64 ओके सो आई मेड अ मिस्टेक हियर सो दैट इज इक्वल टू 4 ओके नाउ दिस 600 कैंसिल्स आउट सो व्हिच इंप्लाइज यू कैन राइट 200 by V is equal to half. That is, V is coming out to be 400 ml. V is coming out to be 400 ml. So, in this way, we have to do the numericals. Okay? This is a very important question so far as your NCERT and entrance exam point is concerned. IIT JEE के लिए तो बहुत ही important problem है बाबा. और नीट के लिए भी इम्पोर्टेंट है सो एनसीईआरटी में ये क्वेश्चन फ्रिक्वेंटली दिस क्वेश्चंस आर फ्रिक्वेंटली आस्क्ड इन योर फाइनल एग्जाम सो बी केयरफुल एंड बी प्रिसाइज व्हाइल सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम्स व्हाट इज आस्क्ड इन द क्वेश्चन एंड व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू सॉर्ट इट आउट ओके सो नेक्स्ट ऑडियो क्वेश्चन करते चलो दैट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन सो दैट इज ऑल्सो अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन सो क्वेश्चन देख के तुमको लग जाएगा कि ये इम्पोर्टेंट है सर हाँ रियली सर दिस कैन बी द इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन So far my experience is concerned, I have seen that these questions are frequently asked in your final as well as your entrance exam. So next question देखते हैं. An unknown gas diffuses 4 times as fast as oxygen. The question is, an unknown gas diffuses 4 times as fast as oxygen. 4 times as fast as oxygen. Okay, 4 times as fast as oxygen. What is the name of the gas? Name the gas. The gas is unknown. You have to name the gas. So very very important question, my dear students. So let's see the solution. So that we know that rate of diffusion of gas by the question is given, rate of diffusion of gas by rate of diffusion of O2 is equal to 4 times. Okay. So this gas diffuses 4 times as fast as oxygen. So R gas by RO2 is equal to 4. Now molar mass of O2 is equal to how many? 16 to the 32. And molar mass of unknown gas का नाम देते हैं हम लोग गैस, ऐसे ऐसे ही गैस लिख रहे हैं. सो इज इक्वल टू क्वेश्चन मार्क. सो वेरी 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 नाइस क्वेश्चन मार्क इज देयर. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू ग्राहम्स लॉ ऑफ डिफ्यूजन व्हाट इज ग्राहम्स लॉ ऑफ डिफ्यूजन? जस्ट नाउ वी हैव सॉल्व दैट इज रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ गैस दैट इज आर गैस बाय आर और टू इज इक्वल टू मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ गैस बाय मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ O2. ओके, ये है ना हमारा. सो दिस आर गैस बाय आर टू इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? 4. सो मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ गैस बाय मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ O2 कितना है? 32 इज इक्वल टू 4. अभी इसको हम स्क्वायर कर देते हैं, स्क्वायरिंग बोथ साइड्स वी विल गेट मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ गैस बाय 32 इज इक्वल टू 4 स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? 16. सो मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ गैस इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच? मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ गैस इज इक्वल टू, यहाँ पे गलती कर दिया मेरे बच्चों, यहाँ पे होगा m O2 by m of gas. यहाँ पे भी होगा m O2 by m of gas. सो m ऑफ गैस निकालना है. ये m O2 हो जाएगा 32 एंड m ऑफ गैस निकालना है हमको. सो m ऑफ गैस इज इक्वल टू 32 by 16 इज इक्वल टू 2. सो मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ गैस आ रहा है हमारा 2. मतलब क्या है मॉलिक्यूलर गैस का नाम? व्हाट कैन बी द नेम ऑफ द गैस? Yes, you are right, my dear students. The gas is nothing but hydrogen. The gas is hydrogen. Okay. So this way you have to sort it out the problems. So I have done few problems. Next we'll move to another topic in my next class. So if you still find any doubts in solving the problems, you go on solving the problems. You just write it to me in my WhatsApp number. So I am here to help you people. The thing is that you have to practice, okay? So with this, I want to end up my session here today. Thank you very much, my dear students, for your patience hearing, and all the best wishes to all of you, okay? Thank you.